the Doctor Who audio dramas. Classic Doctor Who, the way you remember it. Visit us at our website at www.wad.net or on our Facebook page, group/Doctor Who audio dramas.
Explosions, the flames. They're out of control. Got to get out of here. Got to get to the escape pod before it gets to me. No! The wall's caved in. The door won't open. No, please. System, report on escape pod status.
Escape pods 1 through 3, doors inactive. 4 through 11, magnetic seal destabilized. 13 through 16, fuel line ruptured. Chance of successful launch, 4.1%.
Magnetic seal destabilized? That means those pods are adrift. Has no one else survived? That can't be true. There were hundreds of us on board. Wait. System, clarify status of pod 12.
Escape pod 12 in full working order. Chance of successful launch, 100%.
Hello? I can hear... Is someone there? Friend or foe?
Attention all Myrmalir crew. Internal ship stability at 7%. Hull integrity at 5%. All hands evacuate ship immediately.
I'm sorry, I have to go. I can't wait any longer.
Functioning escape pod. Send help.
That's more than enough of that. I don't know why I ever turned it on. We only ever get static. Activate recorder. Voice recognition. Senior Coordinator Bark. Report 812 from Crossharbour Refuelling Station. Solar cycle 11-7. Repairs on the refrigeration unit are ahead of schedule, and the seal on refueling Bay 5 has been dealt with, so we are back to full capacity. Following the moon ray's departure, no further arrivals are expected until the next supply drop in 71 days. There has been some mild fuel degeneration, but this falls within expected perimeters. Preskill and Bramble is hard at work in the underground mine facility, and is making good progress. Praise be the Hypogene. If only that were all true. But telling the truth will only extend this tour of duty, and it is so lonely. If I didn't have this, I don't know what I'd do. It feels silly, locking it away behind two levels of security. But if Bramble were to sneak into my office, I need to keep an eye on her. She seems to do whatever she wants, that one. I'm sorry I'm so far away, we can't even talk properly. What sort of relationship can we have when lunar vagaries and gravity pockets keep interfering with the comm signals?
Hi, Dad. Long time no speak. Sorry I didn't signal last month. There were really bad solar flares.
No worries, it happens.
I have so much to catch you up on. I know it was hard on you for pushing me when I was younger, and I hate to admit it, but you were right.
But I won't hear you say that again.
But don't expect me to say that often. I'm hard at work here. In my sophomore preschooling year, they've assigned me to radioactive substances, which is so exciting. I'm in a cohort of only 12. My friends are so jealous.
Sounds very prestigious.
I don't know how we're gonna make them safer to consume, but I promise I'll do all I can to figure it out. My lecturers say that this was impossible science a generation ago, but we're on the edge of something special here. There must be a way to artificially alter half-lives.
If there is, you'll find it.
Sorry, I've got to dash off. Lecture's in 5. But I wanted to update you. I wanted you to know what I'm doing for the Hypogene.
Praise be the Hypogene.
Anyway, better go. See you soon, Dad.
He always signs off too soon.
Better go. See you soon, Dad.
How long has it been, son? How many months since I saw you? Too long, too long. And all I get are these short messages. How I wish we could talk properly, but I'm stuck here for quite a while longer. I'm sorry I can't reply right now. Not until I get the parts to fix this dratted holopad, but I am proud of you. What's that noise? Does it sound like any distress calls I've ever heard before? What wavelength is it transmitting on? Maybe I can isolate it and get a better listen. Huh? It's gone. It might come back, though. I'll log it in my report. Not that anyone cares about a random groan in the static of deep space.
Sample 914, Igneous Rock. Source, Alkaf Gamma 4. Nope, that's wrong. I'm not paying attention to my own notes. Computer, edit, substitute Gamma 4 for Gamma 5. Right. Applying 2.8 milligrams mentisium, 0.9 milligrams domon, and 3 pascals force. No! No! Turn it off. This isn't working. The mentisium definitely has the right reactive strength, and domon prevents decay. But it can't handle the pressure. And that's essential. How am I supposed to speed up the formation of valuable minerals without the necessary force? There aren't any chemicals known to the Myrmalir that can substitute that essential element. Update experiment log. Failure. What? I did this earlier. Of course I did, of course. I can't seem to focus. No, system. I don't wish to update the result of the experiment. It's exactly the same as it was 4 hours ago. I keep making mistakes today, and it's wasting valuable time. I need to get this to work. The Myrmalir are counting on me. Maybe I'm hungry? Yeah, that seems right. I haven't consumed since waking. Computer, shut down workstation. Authorization, Prescaline Ulam Bramble. What's that noise? Bark! Is that you? He doesn't normally come down to the mine. Must have been a strange echo through the cave, or I'm hearing things.
That was no echo.
She's always late. This station used to pride itself on how smoothly it ran. This new Prescalian may be smarter than her predecessor, but her timekeeping leaves much to be desired.
Oh, Bark. You're already here. Have you been waiting long?
No longer than usual. Is there an issue with the clock in the mine?
Not that I've noticed, no. Go on. Do the safety protocols so we can eat. Giving me this silent treatment?
If you won't take the check seriously, I won't see the point in involving you.
You're the one who keeps reporting that everything is in pristine condition. That this station is working at top productivity? So, who's not taking things seriously? If the Hypogene could see how much rust we deal with here. Not to mention, lack of supplies.
I work tirelessly to maintain this station. We are never in any danger as a result, and that will be the case for the remaining 521 days of my tour of duty. Is that clear?
That you're counting down the number of days until you can leave? Oh, terribly.
Airlock secure. Seal degradation minimal. Internal pressure resistance stable. Now you, Bramble, add your update on your research's progress. For the record, since you neglected to do so last week. You forgot, I believe.
Of course. The last 14 rotations have been productive. A great number of the experiments completed have aided in finalizing a formula for the compression process. 1,411 have been completed, with 1,189 showing signs of success. So that works out as a percentage of 84.27%. I'd call that a highly promising proportion, wouldn't you?
If those numbers are real. Splendid! At this rate, you'll be able to convert useless rock into valuable minerals in no time.
If I can find a way to stabilize the process, then yes.
But that was the issue you had at the beginning of this month. Has that not changed yet?
Those were details pointing me in the right direction. Not necessarily supplying the whole answer. Perhaps maintaining a refueling station and fixing aging equipment is more straightforward than trying to revolutionize a complex scientific process, but if you are secretly an expert in metasomatic processes and can manipulate natural hydrothermic currents in a way that doesn't adversely impact the igneous ferns or hornfels, then by all means, lecture me. Huh? Then why don't we talk about you? How's his skin?
What? How do you know about my son?
You didn't know I knew his name, did you? I overheard you say it while you were talking to yourself about repairs.
He's fine. Well, I'm glad you're doing so well with your work. I look forward to the varied diet that it generates for us. Our rations for the evening have been prepared. Praise be to
the Hypogene. I'm famished.
I heard that in my office earlier, over the radio receiver.
How peculiar. I heard it too, down in the mine. Do you know what it is?
No. That noise sounds like something in pain. That's the motion sensors in Refueling Bay 3. But that's impossible. Nothing is scheduled to come through this sector for weeks. It must be an emergency. Finish your meal, Bramble. I'll send a pulse through the mycelial grid if anything is wrong.
I hope nothing's wrong. The last thing we need, I need, is a surprise inspection.
Out, out! No time to dawdle, it's now or never. A few more seconds and the control room will be smaller than a broom closet.
We were nearly crushed! Why is the TARDIS collapsing in on itself? Did we hit something? That was by far the worst turbulence I've ever encountered.
There was something temporarily unstable in the time vortex that was trying to materialize in our flight path. We phased through each other and should have knocked them out of the vortex, but the TARDIS didn't like it one bit. Her innards got stood around. She'll need time to recover.
So the TARDIS will self-repair?
She'll need a helping hand, but I reckon she'll manage the worst of it herself.
Doctor, where are we? This place is toxic!
The air's thick with some sort of pollutant or emissions.
Like the exhaust from a car. Should we be breathing this in?
Take this hanky and put it over your face. That should help some.
Thanks. Can you see a way out? Looks like a giant garage.
I think this is a refueling station. Good news is they probably have tools we can use to help the TARDIS.
You two, return to your vessel.
Hello, is there an option B? My ship is damaged and locked us out. Can we come to where you are? This air is hardly breathable.
Head towards the speakers. I'll send the lift up. This is highly irregular.
Who are you? And why are you here?
I'm the doctor. This is my friend, Kim Lee. We ran into a spot of bother and need some roadside assistance.
Or whatever the space equivalent is. Whoa. Hello. What? I mean, who are you?
I am Senior Coordinator Nifkin Bark. And you can stop staring at me.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to be rude. You just look a bit like a wolf. A wild creature from my home that is vicious and carnivorous by nature.
Is that how your kind greets strangers? I haven't seen any bipedal organisms in a long time, but I imagine you would take offense if I assumed you're a threat.
Point taken. Can we start again? I'm Kim Lee, a human from Earth.
Never heard of it, so it must be tediously primitive.
You can say that again. Please forgive my friend. She's relatively new to the vastness of space. Now I get the impression you aren't especially pleased that we're here, Mr. Bark.
No, mister. Just Bark. Crossharbour is a place of order and consistency. This is the way of the Hypogene. There has not been an unexpected arrival here in the years I have been serving.
Well, I'm terribly sorry to have disrupted your harmony. Had there been any alternative, we'd have gladly gone there.
Fine. Resources are not infinite, but allowances shall be made.
If you want to be reimbursed, I'm sure I've got some doubloons hidden somewhere in a shoe cupboard, or something more akin to your currency.
We have no need for money. The Hypogene regulates all within its biosphere. What is needed is shared. Come with me and I will assess how best to proceed.
I shouldn't be here. But I can't stay away. Computer, start recording. Wait, no. Terminate research record and access personal diary. This file can't get back to my professors or the Hypogene. Not until I've gotten to the bottom of this. The drilling has unearthed another artifact. This time a remnant of some plastic construction, perhaps a toy to amuse a youngling. Some edges are sharp, so my guess may be wrong. This is the most interesting development yet. Whatever civilization existed here was clearly advanced enough to be processing materials. To have developed methods of manufacturing indicates considerable technological advancement.
What you are uncovering here is significant. You see that.
But how can any of this be here? When I accepted this research post, I was explicitly told that there had never been life on the planet before. That's why it was an ideal place for Crossharbour. Which means either they didn't know, or... Could the Hypogene have lied to us?
Keep digging. There are more secrets to unearth.
If my rudimentary scans picked up these artifacts, there's no way they didn't notice that so much history was buried here when they were constructing the refueling station. Something is hidden here. And I don't know if I should disturb it.
You live for answers. Can you survive with questions?
Will you be quiet? I am trying to think. This is a lot to process.
Right, you two, stay here. I need to update my records and check oxygenation levels. Don't move.
Wait, why is it getting darker? It was perfectly light a minute ago, and suddenly I can barely see my hand waving in front of my face! Are my eyes playing tricks on me, or are the walls glowing faintly? I can't make out much, but at least it isn't pitch black.
I believe our friend Bark is a Myrmalir. The Myrmalir are phosphorescent. They generate their own light, like giant fireflies, so there's no need for the station to have any artificial ones installed. I imagine anyone who arrives to have their ship refueled stays on board while Bark fills up the tank.
Oh, like that time when we were driving around in the 1950s and stayed in the car while the roadside attendant filled the tank?
Exactly like that, but on a far grander scale. The Myrmalir are fungal creatures.
What? Like mushrooms?
but much more developed, which is saying something when you consider how clever mushrooms already are. It's like if you combined the interconnectedness of fungi with the adaptability of plasticine and the intellect of dolphins. Look, the walls and floors are covered in thousands of tiny white threads. They make up the mycelial grid the Myrmalir can connect through.
So they can sense things through the ground, like detachable nerve endings? Wow, they look almost ghostly. It'd be beautiful if this place wasn't so creepy. Do you think he's coming back for us?
Very good, very good. It's safe for you to come in. This is our communal space.
Looks like a mess hole. Speaking of, I'm rather hungry. We haven't eaten since... Was it really that Neptunian sushi?
Hate to break it to you, but we'll have to provide for ourselves. Unless your stomach has a negative pH. You eat an orange for the vitamin C. They consume serendite to help rebuild cells. And since I'm confident you don't fancy nibbling on some rocks and crystals here, I may have a PB&J in one of these pockets.
If you're quite finished, in exchange for you to both stay while I take a look at your ship, you'll need to make yourselves useful. Until the repairs have been completed, I need help with some station maintenance. That's a fair trade.
I'll gladly take a look at whatever you want. I'm a pretty good mechanic, if I may say so myself. Just point me in the right direction.
There are 80 barrels in the mine that need bringing up ahead of the next supply drop.
Ah, so you need a dog's body. Gotcha.
Not what you had hoped for, Doctor?
I do not see what is amusing. The work does need to be done.
My friend is used to being asked to tinker with world-saving gadgets, not fetch and carry. Though, personally, I'm sure it'll do his ego some good.
If you say so. But you'll have to pull your weight as well.
I'll do what I can.
Here we go. What marvelous job do you have in mind for Kim Lee?
Bark to Bramble.
Bramble here? I'm in the lab. I assume all's fine with your little emergency?
You can say that. We have two temporary guests. I've requisitioned one, and I'm sending the other down to help with your research, since it's at such a vital stage. She seems less likely to talk to you in an early grave.
What? She gets the lab work? No fair.
I'll send her down now. Best behaviors, Bramble. They aren't like us. Praise be the Hypogene.
If you say so. Praise be the Hypogene.
There we are. The lift down to the mine in Bramble's lab is out and to the right. Only turn at the very end. There are only three buttons inside the lift, so I imagine you'll be able to figure out what to do.
Up, down, and... what? An emergency alarm?
Come along then, Doctor. We spent enough time dawdling. There's work to be done.
I guess we've got to make the best of it. Have a good day, Kim Lee.
You too! Oh, he's gone already. That man needs to slow down. Right, the lift is over there. Well, Bark was right about the number of buttons, but which is which? There aren't any symbols on them. Great. Okay, I guess I'll have to just pick one and see what happens. Fingers crossed! I'm so glad that was the right one. I was scared to press a button. How ridiculous is that? This dark has me paranoid. I can't let this place get to me. Breathe in, breathe out. I am perfectly safe. The doctor will keep me safe. Or at least he would if he were here. What is he going to do if there's a cave-in and I'm trapped down here? No, no, I don't need him. Breathe in, breathe out. I'm more than capable of getting myself out of scrapes. Like that time the Marsh Witch knocked the doctor out and I had to stop her from permanently ruining the planet's climate. A little darkness isn't enough to spook me. We aren't at the bottom yet! Help! Help! Should I press another button? No, not yet. Stay calm. Think what the Myrmalir would do if they found you panicking. They won't take me seriously. Strange walking mushroom creatures that look like wolves. The universe is so incredible, so diverse. Life comes in so many shapes. Us humans haven't got a clue. Maybe my new home on the colony will be just like this. Close encounters with all sorts of marvelous species all the time. If Buck genuinely can fix the TARDIS and the doctor can get me there. Thank goodness it's going again. Don't do that again, Lift! My nerves are frayed enough as it is. So, here we are. The mine under Crossharbour Station. Let's see what's out here. Or not. I can barely see a few inches in front of me. There's hardly any light coming from those fungal threads down here. Ooh. I feel like I've been swallowed up. This is why I never understood people who like potholing and clambering around caves. Oh, there better not be anything nasty down here. Hello? Is there anyone here? Bramble? Can you hear me? Wait, I know. Find a wall and follow it along. That should help. But where is it? Gosh, how big is this place if I can't even find a wall?
Hello over there.
Oh, hello. Your voice is a bit echoey. I can't tell which way to go.
Head straight from the lift shaft 100 steps. Then turn 20 degrees to the right and walk in a straight line. You should see the light from the lab after a minute or two.
Okay. Here I come. You'd tell me if you were stood right in front of me, wouldn't you?
Don't worry, you can trust me.
I can't believe I'm following a disembodied voice through an alien mine. This feels like the worst idea I've had in a long time. Please don't eat me, please.
So you see, my TARDIS is dimensionally transcendental, which is phenomenally useful for a vessel that travels through time, because you need so much space to store all the cool things that you find on your travels, along with the energy cells and the temporal anatomata and all of the other gubbins. So I suspect my ship is quite probably the most complicated bit of kit you've ever worked on, not to sound patronizing.
An engine is an engine.
Very philosophical, though perhaps a mite reductive. Here, I expect you'll need this quantum hammer.
I'll do what I can, and anything I don't understand, you can give me detailed instructions that I will follow to the letter. Will that placate your concern, or does this lecture on the impressive nature of your vehicle need to carry on?
No, I'm sure you've got it by now. That's quite a direct attitude you've got there. Oh good, a celestial spanner. Better keep that handy.
Not everyone likes to chatter on and on before they get the work done. I was assigned my post on Crossharbour, and I accept that working here means doing what is required.
Is that because of the Hypogene?
Most of our extraterrestrial visitors know nothing of my kind. But you are correct. Everything we do for the Hypogene. The Hypogene delivers what is needed to every Myrmalir. To me, to Bramble, to my son. And so we do what we are told. That is how the system works.
Even this far out? Your homeworld must be light years away.
Distance does not matter. We are still connected. If a Myrmalir were to fail to complete their duty, that would be the greatest crime with the most severe punishment, as I remind Bramble multiple times.
So you don't want to let the Hypogene down. I suppose that's an interesting way to keep your people in line, the threat of disappointment. Like a ruler and parents rolled into one. Now, where do you keep the custard creams?
You're mocking me, Doctor. You may think yourself a genius with your ship of many dimensions, and me a lowly manager with some engineering skills, but I see your words for what they are. If you continue to speak like that, your time on this refueling station will not be pleasant.
I didn't mean...
We're picking up a signal of some sort. I can patch it through to the speaker.
Only one functioning escape pod. Send help. Myrmalir under attack. Only one functioning escape pod. Send help.
That's a distress call. Someone needs our help.
I'm already scanning for the solitary escape pod. The signal is weak. Keeps dropping out.
What? Why have you stopped? What does it say?
Look, this dot here is the escape pod. It's already on the edge of our range. By the time we mobilize to assist, it will be too far away. The escape pod is lost. We should move on. It is what the Hypogene would want.
But there's no other help for light years. You can't give up. If someone is alive in there, they might die before anyone else hears that message.
Cross Harbor's magna clamp has a limited range. It is only meant for maneuvering spacecraft that have already docked. The escape pod is already at the furthest extent we could reach. And examining its trajectory... see? It'll be beyond our magna clamp in under a minute. There's nothing that can be done.
Never say that. Budge up. Every second counts.
What are you doing? You can't interfere with Cross Harbor systems like that.
No time to ask permission. I'm rerouting power from various sections of the energy grid to... huzzah! It worked. I assume this is the magna clamp control? Looks like a joystick. How retro. I've funneled extra power into the magna clamp to temporarily increase its range. I've only bought a few bonus seconds, but it's enough for one attempt. It can be a bit like those claw machines in arcades, but I've spent many a millennia practicing them. Got it! Reeling her in. Did it! Phew, that was close. And before you get mad about this control panel, I can fix that easy peasy. In fact, I can probably get it up and running again in less time than it'll take you to pop up there and check if the escape pod's occupant is still breathing. Wanna race?
Do not touch anything while I'm gone. You've done enough damage already.
But we saved a life. We did the right thing.
Perhaps.
Ah, should have realized how hard it's going to be to repair this without Bark's phosphorescence. Or I could treat it as a challenge. Okay, here goes. I think this is the... ouch! As I was saying, this is the live wire, so this must be... ow! Another live wire. Maybe I should turn it off at the wall first, or find the fuse box.
I trust you didn't touch anything.
Who, me? Nah, I never disobey instructions. Is that...
your ship? I presume so. A blue cuboid. But it is somewhat smaller than you described. A few inches squared, if that.
My TARDIS, my beautiful ship. Don't worry, we'll have you right as rain before you know it. I knew she was damaged, but not that bad. How can the TARDIS fit on your paw?
If it is worse than you thought, maybe your optimism is all you will leave here with.
Let's not talk about that now. How is our newcomer?
He is unconscious. I'm no medic, but that head wound looks bad. If we don't get him the help he needs soon, he'll die. I have some medipacks through here. We should be able to save him.
That's good news. I'm glad something positive has come out of today.
Ah, hello. It's good to see you, in more ways than one.
Ah, you must be the yard woman that Bark told me about. Remind me of your name?
I'm Kim Lee, and it's pronounced human.
Well, I do like to learn new things. Welcome, human. It is good to see a new face. It can be quite galling, spending all this time with only Senior Coordinator Bark for company. Now, perhaps that term means something different to your kind?
Annoying? Almost resentfully so?
Yes, that is too harsh. He is a good worker. Considerate, caring, but always the same. It's wrong to crave even a slight variation. But we can discuss ethics during the break period. Let me think of how best you can help out. Do you know much about geology? The study of rocks?
What is it that you do here? Bark didn't say.
I am a Prescalin. You appear confused. Do you not use that word? I am completing research to fulfill the requirements of a doctorate.
Oh, a PhD student? Wow, your work might be a bit beyond my capabilities then. Wait, your voice... it isn't the one I heard in the cavern out there.
Of course not. I didn't say anything until you got here.
So, who...
I am the one who spoke to you.
Yes, that's the voice I heard. It sounds like it's all around me. Am I going mad? Or can you hear it too? Please say you can.
You have nothing to worry about. That voice is not inside your head. It is real. Why don't you say hello properly rather than scare the poor human?
Hello, Kimmy. It is an honor to meet you.
Bramble, who is that?
That, Kimmy, is the voice of the rock itself.
What? Is this a joke?
Not at all. I am the cave mouth. Have you never met sentient rock before?
I think they're waking up. Hello, I'm the Doctor. This is Bark. What's your name?
I'm Junior Pilot Solent of the Moonray. Where am I?
This is Crossharbour Refuelling Station.
When we found you, you were unconscious in an escape pod, drifting in space, so we presume something happened to your ship. Can you tell us what?
We were here recently. It's a miracle you found me, thank you.
You can thank us later. It's essential you tell us what happened to Moonray. We need to report this back to the Hypogene.
Praise be the Hypogene. I can't remember.
It's okay, you suffered a head injury. Your memories will come back soon. Just take it easy.
What happened to the rest of the crew? Did Primary Captain Justin survive?
No, I don't think so. The escape pods were all trashed. The one I got away in was the only one that was in working order, and I barely got away with my life. There was a lot of damage to the Moonray. It all must have happened too quickly. I can't remember anything else. It's all a blur.
It takes a lot to destroy an entire spacecraft that rapidly.
Come on, think. If there is something out there that is a threat to the station, or the Myrmalir at large, we need to know.
It was there. It was chasing me. I had to run. It would have got me if I...
Solent! Solent, what was it? What was chasing you?
He's passed out. There's a spare medipack on the table if he wakes up. We'll check on him later. The door's locked. He'll be safe in there.
I meant to ask, why does a refueling station have such a sturdy lockup?
We get a few prisoner transports come through this sector. If anything goes wrong with the ships, it's useful to have somewhere to put the dangerous ones while we arrange repairs.
Might be the best place for him.
So I take it you're suspicious of him too?
Maybe not suspicious, but wary. I've seen my fair share of wounds in the past, and most of Solent's look like someone who got their hands dirty, so to speak. Except that deep scratch down his back. That took a lot of force and brutality. To have sustained injuries that severe, he must have been in a fight for his very life. But there's no way to know if he was the victim or the attacker.
We keep tabs on predatory masses. So either there's something out there we don't know about but has somehow taken a dislike into my kind, or Solent is actively deceiving us. It would explain why he seemed so shifty.
You're worried, aren't you, about Solent and what he could be capable of? If only he could remember what happened. That could be key to stopping whatever destroyed the Moonray from striking again. Because there could be some cosmic horror out there responsible for killing hundreds of Myrmalir.
And if it could destroy an entire spaceship, following the signal of an escape pod would be child's play.
We've already let the danger in. Oh, Bark, have I made a terrible mistake and saved the life of a mass murderer?